You gotta stand strong.
I am strong.
You're spaghetti.
Spaghetti can be strong.
You got jello knees.
Jello can be strong.
What jello are you eating?
Diane, stop!
Look, I'll just wear one. It's no big deal.
No big deal?
It'll be my thing.
No big deal. No big deal.
My signature style.
Have you lost your mind?
What's going on?
What's going on, Diane?
We are in a state of crisis.
What's the crisis?
This.
What's that?
It's not what it is, it's what it is.
Okay, what it is.
Diane.
It's no big deal.
Diane, were you or were you not wearing this sock when you got your dream job at Kitty Kitty Kochi Kochi?
Since when do you work there?
Last month, I told you.
And were you or were you not wearing this sock when you aced your Spanish final?
You aced your Spanish final?
Last week, I told you.
And when Trent Henderson Scopenhauser talked to you?
Trent Henderson Scopenhauser talked to you?
You were there.
Do you pay attention to anything we do?
Sure I do. Hey, is that one of your lucky socks? The lucky sock? The lucky socks?
Not socks, sock.
One sock, one odd sock.
Where's the other one?
Heh heh heh, crisis.
Tell Nicole where the other one is.
My dryer ate it.
Luck doesn't work in the odd, Diane.
Lucky only works in pairs. A pair of socks.
Why do you care about Diane's luck?
This isn't just any luck.
The whole world should care about this luck.
Universe aligning luck.
Kitty kitty coachy coachy luck.
Henderson Scopenhauser luck.
This is not something we let fade away because an appliance goes haywire.
What are you supposed to do?
They want me to confront my dryer.
What?
You can do it.
Why?
To get the sock back.
Give back the sock or else?
Exactly.
You gotta stand up for yourself.
I can't.
Why not?
It's an inanimate object, works for me.
Nicole, you're not helping.
Can't you just open up the back and see what's there?
This is not about socks. This is bigger than socks.
It's about pants?
Nicola!
I'm telling you, I can't!
Why not?
My dryer is very temperamental. You use the wrong fabric softener and she won't do things for weeks. She's very sensitive.
What are you saying?
The dryer took your lucky sock on purpose?
No.
I think so.
Like a punishment or something?
Like a message.
Yes.
What?
You've been leading us down the garden path. This is an entirely different scenario. This is not a confrontation scenario.
I know. I'm terrified to even go in the basement.
Guys?
But you need that sock.
Fess up. What did you do?
Mix darks and lights?
Dryers don't punish without a reason. You're not laying out the full enchilada.
I didn't think it was a big deal.
Are we on camera or something?
I thought it was a harmless, offhanded, casual remark.
What did you say?
I may have said harmlessly. It really... I said I love my dryer cleaner. It was metaphorical.
Your dryer doesn't know that.
You can't be careless with appliances and electronics. They have fragile feelings, you know. My laptop is so mad at me.
Sheila?
Sheila.
Sheila? Why?
She thinks I'm two-timing her with myself.
You can't ignore her. She'll start losing your files and then you'll be screwed.
I don't believe this.
This is serious, Diane.
This is an emergency.
What do I do?
Beg.
Please, Mrs. Dryer, forgive me.
Please, give me my sock back.
You're the best dryer in all the world.
I'll never disrespect you again.
I've got my dry cleaner.
Why do I have to do that?
Desperate times, Diane.
Please.
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 You guys can't be serious.
Not now, Nicola. Let's go.
Now?
Make it good, or that sock's a limp burger.
So I'm standing in front of the whole school.
So I'm on stage, I have a very small part.
So I'm on my way home from practice.
But I firmly believe there are no small parts, there are only small actors.
It's hot out. It's really, really hot out.
Sure I do.
It's some kind of world environment, world recycling, some kind of save the world kind of day.
I'm not gonna be bitter about this.
It's not my fault practice is outside. That's where the track is.
I'm supposed to read a poem.
I had to get home, didn't I?
I'm not gonna be bitter even though I am a senior.
Save the world poem.
I just can't teleport myself from one place to another.
I hate save the world poems.
When it's hot out, I sweat. I sweat when it's hot out.
I will take the high road. I will practice my four lines with grace and humility, and I will steal the show. Ha!
Newsflash, I sweat. Everybody does. Even the people who say they don't do. Running equals sweat. It's the laws of nature. So there are these girls in the back of the bus, and they're talking and laughing.
The only reason I'm in the environment club is because my parents said, join more clubs. You'll get into a better school if you look like you're more well-rounded. They didn't say I was, I just have to look like I am.
Oh, I get it. They're looking at me and laughing about me and talking about me.
I'll be so brilliant with my four lines, my four tiny lines, that everyone will be devastated that I was on stage for mere seconds. It's a brilliant plan. Opening night comes. I'm prepared, so devious. I'm ready to spread brilliance and devastation.
So whatever, I'm in the environment club, but I hate the people in the environment club. They're serious about the environment. It's not a fun club. It's very much a the earth is dying kind of club. Every day the earth is dying, every day. Which I know, we should be concerned about the environment, but can't we be concerned and eat pizza at the same time every once in a while?
What did I do that's so funny?
But I'm a trooper. No one can say I don't troop. So I start reading the stupid Save the World poem.
The back of my neck goes red.
And I can see my friends out of the corner of my eye, off to the side, laughing.
I try to turn so I can't see them, but I still hear them.
I try to turn so I can't see them, but I can still hear them.
Did I miss my cue?
I don't want to be laughed at because my parents made me join the environment club.
I missed my cue.
The bus stops and I can hear the girls get up.
My cue!
I'm purposely not looking. Then one of them stops in front of me.
I'm supposed to say something. I look up on stage and everybody's staring at me. I look into the audience and everybody's staring at me. And I can't remember my lines. Not one.
Honey, you should take a shower before you ride the bus. You stink. And off they go laughing.
And I run off stage.
And I fart. Loudly. Right in the middle of the poem. Right in the middle of the assembly.
I can hear the audience laughing as I run. At me. I don't stop running till I reach the farthest bathrooms.
I had practice, stupid girls.
I wonder if it's possible to hide in the bathroom for the rest of my life.
It's a spectacular fart. One of my best. I'm not in the environment club anymore.
Gotta keep one jump ahead of the bread line, one swing ahead of the sword. I steal only what I can afford, and that's everything. One jump ahead of the lawman, that's all, and that's no joke. These guys don't appreciate I'm broke. Just a little snack, guys.
Rip him open, take it back, guys.
I'm a teacher, hit dog face facts. I'm a teacher, friend or two.
Oh, it's out of in the bottom. He's become a walking rising crime.
My boy bear is empty as in bottom.
Wait till we have got a stupid tomorrow. I don't really got the time.
Of my big holes. The bees are buzzing in the trees to make
for me. You look under the rocks and plants and take a glance at the fancy ants. Maybe try a few. The bare necessities of life
will come to you.
Susie, and she had a favorite pair of socks she wore to bed every night because her feet got cold, and the socks were very warm. They were made of wool and brightly colored, red at the top, orange at the heel and the toe, and yellow everywhere else. When she looked at them on her feet, the colors reminded her of campfires, of kitchen stoves, of the sun when it's rising. Warm things. She loved those socks. One morning, she started to take off the socks so she could put on some slippers, and that's when the first weird thing happened. She couldn't get them off. It wasn't like they were glued or anything. The wool would move easily on her skin and she could slip her hand inside between the socks and the foot. They just wouldn't come off. She called for her sisters, Elsie and Tilly.
Come here, Elsie. Come here, Tilly. My socks are stuck.
That's goofy. Socks don't get stuck.
You probably just got jelly on your feet.
There's probably boogers in there.
See what you did? You made Susie cry.
No one believes me.
We believe you.
Woof.
I don't get these off.
Yeah, Elsie, let's help our sister.
And that's when the second weird thing happened. Elsie and Tilly's hands were stuck to the socks.
Oh no, I'm stuck to the sock that's stuck to my sister.
Me too, I'm stuck to the second sock.
I've got two socks stuck to my feet and a sister stuck to eight socks. What to do now? This has never happened before. Well, I think you should hold all sorts of different things and see what sticks and what doesn't.
I got a waffle stuck to my stomach once.
That's because you spilled syrup on your stomach. Well, I think you should hold all sorts of different stuff and see what sticks and what doesn't. You had the cereal box this morning. It didn't stick to you, right?
Right.
Oof. And the bowl didn't stick to you either, right?
Right.
So not everything sticks. Let's find out what sticks and what doesn't.
Just then, their dog, whose name was Bop, walked over to see what was going on. Bop was big and old and shaggy. Bop was a pretty cool dog. Susie liked Bop a lot. Bop came over and this girl put her arms around him. It made her feel better to hug this dog she had grown up with, had spent her entire life with. Bop licked her face and she left, and she tried to push his face away. And that's when the third weird thing happened. Susie was stuck to Bop.
We were all stuck together. I thought you said I wasn't going to stick to anything else.
I guess I was wrong.
I guess you were.
Well, you're so smart. Tell us why. Tell us why the socks stick. Tell us why Bop sticks. Tell us why we stick.
Because she loves us.
What? She loves us all.
And that's when the last weird thing happened. Everything quit sticking.
That's the reason we're all stuck. Because she loved us all so much, she couldn't bear to let us go. She was scared of losing us.
Is that true?
We're all stuck together, even when we're apart. Love sticks things together. The thing, it's so strong, the thing it's holding won't even come apart. We don't need you to stick to us. We're already stuck to everybody else. This is life. This is what it is. We don't have any other choice.
So, we're stuck, we're always stuck with each other, even when we're not stuck to each other.
We'll always be together as we are in this room right now.
Susie looked around the room. Outside, the sun was climbing in the sky, and sunlight was streaming through the window. It was shining on Elsie's face, and on Bob, and Tilly's face, and on Bob's face. Everyone was smiling, even Bob. They all just sat on the floor and looked at each other and smiled. In the middle of the room, there was the pair of wool socks just lying there, the socks that Susie loved so much, and she figured if those socks had mouths, they'd be smiling too.
I wish I was in another group.
You say that every year.
Is it too much to ask for a little less commentary? You're always talking.
Vio's just excited.
That's right. Vio's not doing anything wrong.
We're supposed to be observing, not talking. That's the point.
Rule's right. You're not supposed to talk during the session.
Watch it there, Faye. You're giving me whiplash. So I get carried away. I love this time of year.
Me too, just like Christmas.
There's that feeling in the air. We get out of school, and you guys are like my second cousins I only see once a year.
Aw, and I didn't get you anything.
I so wish I was in another group.
And the list is like a big present right under the tree.
Stop crowding me, I'm the group leader, I get it first.
Hail, hail, pay the bill, cause someone's about to go to jail!
You are a regular poet, you should do that for a living.
Uh-uh, poet? I can see my dad's face all over that one.
The only poets I know are scofflaws.
You shouldn't be a poet then, Vio.
Like I would.
Here, Rhea.
Didn't your brother do a lot of writing in school?
No.
No, it was something else out of the ordinary.
You must be thinking of someone else.
That reminds me.
You go next, Vio. Merry Christmas.
Thanks!
Hey, group leader, so why'd they up us another day? We're in here a whole week.
It's for our own good.
The observation is a necessary element of our education.
Very good, Faye.
You like my sweater? It's new. I bought it for the occasion. It's nice. I thought you were going to wear those pants you bought last week.
Guess I forgot.
You have to present yourself properly. If we're going to have long-standing careers in this department, we have to start dressing properly. We have to show them we're up for the task. Sweatpants are not up for the task.
Why not?
Am I talking to you? Hey, Vio, I almost forgot to ask, what were the offense officers doing at your house this morning?
Huh?
I was driving by and I saw a black van in your driveway.
How do you know where I live?
You didn't do anything wrong, did you, Vio?
Of course not.
But it was a pickup car.
Well, no one got picked up. I'm here and my parents are safe and sound at home.
What about your brother?
What about him?
I was just...
Keep your nose out of my business! You too!
Sorry, Vio.
I'm not upset!
You can't blame me for being curious.
You're not curious. You're bloodthirsty.
You shut up. I've had just about enough of you.
Okay, creepy eye.
Don't call me that.
Or what? You're gonna turn me in?
I might.
Oh, I'm shaking in my prefab boots.
You should be, you snot-nosed scofflaw. Wouldn't be sorry then.
Stop it!
You know, don't you? You know.
Yeah?
You are bloodthirsty.
After you go after Vio, are you coming after me? Is that how this works? Or are you all in on it?
What are you talking about?
It's for our own good.
And how come there are so many infractions? Crime of infraction. What is that? Is that shoplifting? Destroying a storefront?
Yeah, that's enough.
It's okay to lock up a shoplifter. It's okay to lock up someone who makes a wrong decision, who is in the wrong place at the wrong time.
If you don't watch it, you're gonna get yourself locked up.
It's okay to lock up someone who's sick.
They all deserve to be locked up. They wouldn't be here if they didn't. The system keeps us safe, Rhea. You know that. Don't listen to whatever tourists.
The streets are safe. My home is safe. My family's safe. Then why do I feel so afraid all the time?
What am I afraid of? I lay awake at night, my heart thumping so fast I can't fall asleep. The world is supposed to be safe. Why don't I feel safe?
What?
You shook your head.
I can't shake my head.
You shook your head in disgust.
Did I?
You shook your head in disgust at me.
Don't flatter yourself.
I know what I saw. You know, I know you, Jennifer Stephanopoulos.
Walkathon.
What?
Please.
Please what?
You hate exercise.
It's not exercise, it's walking.
That's hardly a winning attitude.
Who's got the winning record? That's right. Me.
My raffle is going to kick your walkathon to the curb.
Nobody cares about your stupid raffle.
I'm going to win and you'll be walking in my dust.
I'm
going to
beat you so bad you'll be crying raffle ticket tears.
That makes no sense.
My brother lost his toe last week in a freak anvil accident. That's something new in my life. Well, not really my life, but my immediate worldview. Something you might not know seeing how caught up you've both been. I suppose all accidents involving anvils are quite freakish of nature, but this one was quite unexpected.
The toe turned black and just fell right off.
Freakish, but fascinating too in a weird, unexpected way.
What are you doing?
Talking.
Why?
We're not talking.
I know.
Talking is a distraction.
Hey, I'll talk. I'll talk about how you're going to lose so bad, you'll be crying a walkathon tears.
I know what you're doing. Oh, I know. I know, Jennifer Stephanopoulos. You think you can wig me out? You think you can make me lose my focus? Lose my cool? I am uber cool, Missy Ma'am. I am ultra uber cool, and don't you forget it!
That doesn't make any sense. You make no sense, Sleep.
Don't call me that.
Would you prefer drip?
No.
Sprinkle?
You know my name.
Shower?
You're going down.
Okay, stop talking. Stop talking. You, stop talking now. We're going to have a conversation like regular human beings because there is something I want to discuss. No head shakes, no snide, chirpy comments. I will talk, and then you will talk back in a moderate and pleasant tone. That's how normal people do it. You two suck at fundraising, not because you can't sell the most tickets or walk the most miles, but because once a year, you two become total monsters. We're not talking monsters. I'm gonna sell more tickets than you monsters. Forget your friends, monsters. And for what? You don't even get anything good if you raise the most.
Well, it's for charity.
They say your name on the announcements.
I don't get why you two can't be normal people and compete like normal people and talk like normal people. I like talking. That's what friends do. They talk. And I thought you guys were my friends. I thought you didn't say anything. Neither of you.
What are we talking about?
The screenplay.
I kept waiting and waiting for so long. And then I had to find out from Paula's sister's boyfriend's cousin that you read it and didn't like it.
Paula's sister's boyfriend's cousin is a troublemaker.
Maybe, but is she a liar? No, you are.
We didn't lie.
Not talking is lying. Not saying what you feel is lying. I hate jelly beans. I could care less how many are in this jar. It's 127. There. Now you know. Do with it what you will.
We didn't want to hurt your feelings. That's why we didn't say anything.
I've never read a full screenplay before. A 200-page screenplay. Ah!
A friend would have talked to me about it. Not leave me in a lurch. Not tell someone's sister's boyfriend's cousin instead.
She is such a troublemaker.
Okay, you want to know what we thought?
Jen, don't.
You're right. Not talking is lying. So here it is. The truth, we didn't tell you, I don't think, Rain.
Oh, great. Mac, the wandering clarinet player is not, you know.
No.
You get the idea.
You have to say it. All the words.
Why can't you just fill in the blanks and figure it out?
All the words.
But that's hard.
Jen?
Okay, it's bad, really bad.
Why?
There was a lot of wandering.
In foggy swamps.
They're not swamps. She wanders the moors.
I don't know what that is.
It's a British swamp.
And what's with the clarinet?
No one likes the clarinet.
I know. That's why she wandered. Okay, say it full out.
You didn't like your screenplay.
And you?
I didn't like it. It was the worst thing I've ever read.
Okay.
Why aren't you upset?
We just crushed your dreams, your aspirations, turned them into origami swans.
Stop talking. Why okay?
I knew you didn't like it. I just wanted you to say it full out. All the words. No blanks. Like a friend.
Are we good?
Yeah. Do you guys want my jelly beans?
Aren't you going to fundraise?
I don't need to. I won.
Why are we doing this again?
It looks cold.
It would.
What are we doing here?
Skiing.
Standing.
Fearing for our lives.
That's an image.
No, we're not.
We're excellent skiers. We're the best darn skiers in the whole world. Watch us ski down the hardest slope.
Are you imitating me?
I think so.
Don't mind me. I'm just here fearing for my life. At top of, what's this thing called again?
Stinking dog face.
Stinking dog face. Mount stinking dog face.
It's rather descriptive. Creates a real image right away. Excellent marketing.
Oh, let's give them a medal.
Do they do that?
What do you want? Those boys liked us. They liked us. They talked to us. I couldn't help myself. They asked if we skied and they smiled.
Those smiles were something.
They smiled with her eyes.
Those eyes were something.
How could I say anything but yes?
There is a grand canyon of differences between yes I can ski and yes I can ski smelly dog face. Stinking dog face.
hope they still like us when we're on podcast.
I thought we were going to do the bunny hill.
You can't impress a boy with the bunny hill.
Everybody skis. We have to ski. Just because we have a ski hill in our town does not mean that we have to follow the Pied Piper. And you, with your eyes and your smiles. We so could have done the bunny hill.
Sorry, Slope.
What?
The bunny hill. It's called Sorry Slope.
I'm telling you right now, those boys would not have liked us if we told them we were going down Sorry Slope.
We could have done Nova's Molar, or he is Holer.
Who names these runs?
Marketing mavens, I'm telling you.
I hate this.
Why are you so pessimistic, huh? Maybe we can do it. Maybe we can make it down this hill. Maybe we can take the light from those boys' eyes and absorb it, like osmosis. We can take the energy from their smiles and it'll turn us into expert skiers.
I can feel it. I feel that energy. We will make it down this hill. Stay with me. We will make it down this hill.
We will make it down this hill.
You too. Say it.
We will make it down this hill.
Louder.
We will make it down this hill.
We will conquer stinking dog face.
We will conquer stinking dog face.
Beat dog face. Beat dog face.
Beat dog face.
Beat dog face.
I feel great. Do you really think we could make it down this hill? Do you really think that we have a chance to get those boys?
Not a snowball's chance in hell.
Oh.
It's okay. Win some, lose some.
Right.
There'll be other boys.
Other boys?
But what do we do now?
Well, we can stay on top of the hill and freeze to death, or we can get eaten alive by animals.
Why am I friends with you?
Or we could go down the hill, face first probably, with many broken limbs and abrasions along the way.
I'm not seeing a happy ending here.
We could scream for help and the snow patrol will come get us. Afterwards, we'll have to suffer the lingering and constant humiliation for years to come that we were rescued.
And no boys.
Nope.
Singing, it's a brand new day.
It's a brand new day.
I see
big cabin. There was a big cabin. It had a bunch of little kids.
It had a bunch of little kids.
There was a big cabin.
There was a big cabin.
It had a bunch of little kids.
It had a bunch of little kids.
Saying glow, saying glow. Some pretty great advice.
nice. We love you, Kathy. Erin is the nicest gal. She is our very best pal. She lives right next to the pond. We have such a special bond. We love you, Erin. Stephen's cooking is the best. He hardly ever rests. He has got the biggest heart. Did you know he's super smart? We love you, Stephen. Grumpy Grizz works real hard. He is always out there in the yard. We don't get to see him much this year. So when we do, we always cheer. We love you, Grumpy. Dedicated. She keeps us all so motivated. She's a teacher, mentor, and friend. And she will be there till the end. We love you, Anna. Alexis is our fearless leader. She's always there when we need her. Thank you for giving us this camp. You are the number one champ. We love you, Alexis. Thank you, Outcasts, for all that you do. We wouldn't be the same without you. Thank you, Outcasts, for all that you do. We wouldn't be the same without you.
Got any pentless?
Nope. Well, that okay.
Maybe try Cohen?
Alright.
Any ideas for the cabin skit, buddy?
Coronavirus!
No, like, really. No, really.
I hate you.
No, 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 stop,
no,
stop.
Not that, not that.
Well, that was a waste of time.
I mean, I don't know. Maybe we could try Tyler and Brady?
You probably have some good ideas.
What's up?
Oh! We were just gonna look for you.
Why?
Well, we were looking for ideas for the cabin skit and everyone else ran off.
I mean, we could make a cabin skit about not knowing what to do for a cabin skit.
No, that's boring. Wait! I have an idea. What if we made a cabin song?
That's a good idea!
A one, two, three,
wait,
four!
Wait! We don't have enough time for that.
No, whatever.
Fancy.
and she'll freak out a lot. We love you, Kira. Sam, this is the marquee song. Come join us, it might be long. Sam is always up early, making noise and needing to pee. She needed to finish her book today, but she's actually 100 pages away. Maddie always reads our books. She always finishes them before we look. Maddie can't do a handstand, because last time she had a bad landing. Rip Maddie's back. Emmy won't stop dancing to TikTok songs all day long. She never stops. Don't expect too much from Emmy, even though she's really funny. Dylan brought Peppa here. She fills our cabin with laughter and fear. She makes a bracelet every day and loses her stuff, which makes her go crazy. Lastly is Lily. She's got 800 Red Sox tees. She is really quiet, but when she talks, she's never wrong. We call her Lil Liz. This is the Marquee song. Thank you for listening along. Sorry it was so long. Goodbye, CCS.
Inside and out. Still is. Alright, next track.
Lady, run down to the riptide. Take it away to the dark side. I won't be your left hand man.
Hazel, oh, I miss her so much. Okay, last track, I think.
I will make you
been chosen to fight to the end. Let's meet them as they enter the arena, shall we? From Gershwin Cabin, Chloe Nato! Woo! From Marquee Cabin, Ripley Chance! Woo! From Schubert Cabin, Molly Gould! Woo! From Imperial Cabin, Nevaeh Angel! Woo! From Paramount Cabin, Josie Wood! Woo! And last but not least, from Globe Cabin, Nora O'Malley! Woo! And of course, I am your host, Dr. Mr. Bubble Butt. The arena, like previous years, has been the beautiful campus of Camp CenterStage. However, this year, the arena is a little bit more magical, if I say. In a survival game of wits, brute strength, and luck, only one will survive. So, let the games begin! Day one, it already looks like we have two people finding shelter. Nevaeh is climbing a tree, and Josie is on the hunt for a bathroom. Ripley is heading straight to the cornucopia, Nelson Hall, for supplies. And Molly is hunting for food at Yulin Pond. Also, seems like Nora is, panicking in the woods. Night one is over and everyone has survived. Day two, Nora's out in the woods. Let's listen in.
I need food. Ooh, a bush.
She found a bush. She's eating it without Ariel's supervision. She's turning into a plant. We've lost our first tribute. Finally, we zoom in on Josie, who's finally found a bathroom. But we've designed this toilet to fight back! We've lost our second tribute. Day two is over. Day three. Nevaeh has finally found the perfect tree to climb. But it seems like something's changing within her. Her animalistic instincts are coming out, and she's turning into a bird. She's flying away. She's not stopping. She's gone. We only have three tributes left, folks. Day three is over. Now, let's zoom into Molly, who has found herself with an intense sugar craving.
I need food.
Do you smell cake?
I smell cake.
Inside.
She found something in the sleeping bag. She's going in. However, like I said, folks, this is no ordinary arena. The sleeping bag is magical, and it's taking over. And she's gone. Our fourth tribute is lost. Now we only have two tributes left, folks. We have Chloe and Ripley. Now, I didn't say this before, but there is a leech hidden in campus trying to find at least one of them to snatch. Let's see how the fight goes. Ripley is going up to Chloe. They're swimming in Yulin Pond. They're diving. I see a leech. It's going to Ripley. It's going to Ripley. She's attaching onto her knee. Oh my gosh, the leech is taking over Ripley. She's falling. And our last tribute is gone. Ladies and gentlemen, we have our victor, Chloe Nato from Gershwin. See you next year, folks. Yeah, Gershwin.
Hello, viewers. Today is a story of the series of unfortunate events of how Paramount is sleeping for eternity. Silence your phones and no speaking and enjoy the show.
What a beautiful day.
Oh, look at those clouds.
Sleep.
What could have happened here?
Oh no, Nash is sleeping. We have to call the detective.
I'll do it. Detective Sarancho, we need help.
What's Ethan the problem?
He came in here.
He's sleeping.
He's asleep. Okay, one at a time. Who are you?
I'm Mrs. Dove.
Who are you?
I'm Colonel Winchelbottom.
Who are you?
I'm Professor Peach.
And who are you?
I'm Sir Baloo.
So what happened here? One at a time.
He just fell asleep.
We walked in here
and we for a snack and now he's asleep.
Okay.
And he was just here.
Okay. Let me just think real quick. Hold on, I'll be right back.
Sleep.
I don't know who the killer could be.
Oh no.
He's asleep.
Oh my god. What happened?
He just fell asleep.
Did you see who did it?
No. He's asleep.
Do you know who this man is?
No, I don't.
No, you don't. Okay. I'll be right back once again.
Sleep.
I really don't know who it could be. Like, honestly. We all are bad lying, so... I can't tell. What?
It's totally him.
I am so confused. Okay. What? How'd you know that man?
He's my husband.
He's your husband. How do you know him?
He's my friend.
Your friend. Okay. So husband and friend. Can you tell me a little bit about me right there?
We got engaged like yesterday.
Yesterday. Okay, your turn.
Yeah, I saved him from the apocalypse.
Okay. I'll be right back once again. Let me just think real quick. I think I know who the killer is. Is that wife? I'm highly sure it is. Okay.
Hello, Dr. Sinatra.
I knew it! Okay. You don't have to do anything. Please, just back up, please. Please, don't. Please, just don't.
Sleep.
Me.
won't grow up.
I will never even try.
I will never even try.
I will do what Peter tells me.
I will do what Peter tells me.
And I'll never ask why.
And I'll never ask him why.
We won't grow up.
We won't grow up.
We will never grow a day.
We will never grow a day.
And if someone tries to make us.
And if someone tries to make us.
We will simply run away.
We will simply run away. I won't grow up.
I won't grow up.
No, I promise that.
Everybody can be that guy. Night is long and the music. not just dancing. But let me hit the stage, I wanna take my bow. Cause mama, I'm a big girl now.
About time you showed up.
What's that?
It's Dragon's Lair. Brian came by yesterday and dropped it off. He said it wasn't as good as the real thing, but at least it gave me practicing. He helped me get to level 13, the one where the castle's under siege.
That's cool.
He's a pretty decent guy, Brian is.
Yeah, he is. You were right and I was wrong, but I'm wrong about most people, so.
The important thing is, you always change your mind about them.
I brought something for you. The traveling pants. Yeah, I just got them back from Lena.
The one in Greece?
Yeah, she said that we were right all along, that they really are magic, and, well, I don't know the details, but I do know Lena, and for her to say that means it must be true. So, I was thinking, maybe you could have them for a while.
They didn't fit me, remember?
Yeah, I know, but that doesn't really matter, okay? None of it really matters. Listen, you have to take them, Bailey. You have to let them help you. Please. I know you're tired, okay? But you can't give up. These pants will give you a miracle. You have to believe.
But Tibby, the pants have already worked their magic on me. They brought me to you. I want you to do something for me.
What?
Finish your movie.
Why?
Because you can.
Dawn the next morning, all the lower valley was covered with mist. The clouds changed from a gray to a pink, and the mist was touched with gold. There was a silent moment when everything held its breath. Then the sun rose.
Golly, that's sure pretty.
Wouldn't it be cool to be able to paint that sky?
Too bad it can't stay like that.
Nothing gold can stay.
What? Go pull on my red ones.
I was remembering. Nature's first green is gold, her hardest hue to hold.
Her early leaf's a flower, but only so an hour. It goes on.
Well, you go on.
Then leaf slips side to leaf, so Eden sank to grief. So dawn goes down today. Nothing gold can stay.
Where'd you find that?
Robert Frost wrote it. He meant more to it than I'm getting.
How come you remember it?
Because I kept trying to figure it out. Never quite got what I meant by it.
I never really noticed colors in clouds and stuff until you started reminding me of them. Seems like they were never even there before.
I couldn't tell the others about stuff like that. I couldn't even remember the poem around them. They don't dig, just the soda pop, sometimes.
And maybe cherry bombs. I guess we're different.
Shoot, maybe they are.
I was so tired of baloney, I got sick looking at it. We'd eaten all the candy bars, and I was dying for a Pepsi. By that time, I'd read up to Sherman's Siege of Atlanta, and I owed Johnny $150 from poker games. I was beginning to think I'd always lived in a church, or maybe during Civil War, or both.
Is that a fire?
At the church?
Come on, we gotta go.
Thank you.
Yeah.